Bacteria are everywhere, and they're incredibly versatile. They can get us sick, they're essential good guys in our digestive system, and they can almost defy the laws of physics to create a fluid that could basically power a perpetual motion machine. I didn't see that one coming. Okay, some vocab here. For fluids, friction is expressed as viscosity. The less friction in a fluid, the lower its viscosity. Superfluids are materials that seem to not be bound by the power of friction. They have frictionless flow and therefore zero viscosity, which means they aren't stopped or slowed down by their internal motion, and so they don't lose momentum when moving. Give it one first push and then you're good. It'll just keep going. For the most part, this property has only been observed in liquid helium when it's at close to absolute zero, and its behavior is due to some funky quantum stuff. But scientists have now observed this phenomenon in water. I mean, can you imagine what we could do with water that moves on its own? Now, I bet you saw this coming. It's not just any old water. It's water filled with E. coli. Now, if that makes you squirm a little, trust me, I get it. Usually when we hear the name of that bacteria, it's in the context of a nasty outbreak of a disease we're hoping not to catch. But there's a lot more to this little creature than the bad rap it catches in the press. See, usually when you add little bits of things to water, pieces of dirt, clumps of sand, other particulate matter, the motion of that water slows down. That's because the surfaces of the particulate are exerting extra friction on each other and on the water, giving the fluid a higher viscosity, meaning it takes more energy to keep the whole thing swirling around. You'd think that adding organisms would do the same, but that's where you'd be wrong, my friend. Bacteria are full of surprises and not always bad ones. If you put E. coli in water, they swim. They all swim in their own directions with no real organized movement. They don't usually have their act together. But if there are enough of them, the ripples caused by each of their little body's movements starts to affect the other bacteria's directions. Their movement starts to be more collective. And when around 10 to 20% of your water is filled with bacteria, they start to form tiny swirling currents. But at this point, their direction and movement are still pretty random. They don't radically change the behavior of the water. But then, when you add a force, say you put some of this bacteria-filled water between two microscope slides, the motion gets organized. The shearing force of the glass slide makes all of the bacteria align their collective movement in a particular direction because they have these irregularly shaped oblong bodies. This pushes on the water in a way that makes that water exhibit superfluid properties. Zero viscosity. Those little guys could just keep rolling and rolling and no one can stop them. Okay, Marin, tone it down. No one can know you want bacteria to take over the world. The experts are still a little unclear on the nitty-gritty physics specifics of how the bacteria's motion does this, but the effect is real. The recently published experimental data is supported by previous theoretical work and has some crazy real-life implications. Because the motion of a superfluid is frictionless and therefore only needs to be set into motion once, there is a potential for it to be used as a fuel. You could set your super water in motion, which would take some initial energy investment, and then you watch its motion power a motor or a turbine, essentially forever. I say essentially because the solid moving parts of the motor itself would probably be slowed down by friction, so you'd need to give it a nudge every now and then. Plus, when we're talking about a hypothetical motor, at this point we're talking pretty small and not necessarily that fast. Scaling this operation up in any way is gonna require a lot more work. And then there's the whole problem of the fact that bacteria are living organisms, so you have to feed them. You gotta fuel the fuel, so to speak. And they're kind of picky. You really have to get their care and feeding right for them to work properly. So that's an issue that needs to be reckoned with. There's lots more work to be done in uncovering the details of just how this does what it does, but superfluids powered by bacteria are exciting. And not just for their potential as a fuel, but also because their superfluid characteristics could allow them to move into spaces on their own without having to be forced or injected, meaning they could help us do things like clear up spilled pollutants. But for now, we're just inching towards that future. Special thanks to our sponsor today, domain.com. Domain.com is awesome, affordable, reliable, and has all the tools you need to build a new website. They can fulfill all your website needs. They offer .com and .net domain names and intuitive website builders. They have over 300 domain extensions to fit your needs from .club to .space to .pizza. Take that first step in creating an identity online and visit domain.com. For more on the surprising ways E. coli can generate energy for humans, check out my other video here on bacteria-powered solar cells. And make sure you subscribe for all things microbes. Thanks for watching.